quiet this afternoon. Mm-hmm. For the dedication to the children of the lake. As the generous inheritors of the late Clea Edelblum's vision for a children's prayer school, Dana and Rick have spent the past 3 years investing their time and resources into making this vision come true. Under their leadership, the program is flourishing with creative crafts, spirit-filled stories, and experiential lessons in the prairie ecosystem. Dana and Rick make sure that every child is comfortable and included. They are traveling our way for the week. The children demand to know where Ms. Dana and Mr. Rick are. Okay.
Oh, yes, and Carpenter.
And Carpenter.
The quiet dog.
The mascot.
He's a board wing. He's a pretty quiet dog. All right, gotta
get a picture.
I'm getting Carpenter. He's going to need it.
Yeah, I think I'm just going to go like this. Yay.
Thank you.
You can sit down, Clyde. Yeah.
My cheese just
like you had said.
Thank you for all you do. I'm grateful and
like set.
I don't like how it is.
Systems stealing and death.
Our tears have been our food day and night.
Within our souls, deep calls out to deep.
O Creator, Sustainer, Redeemer, hear the cries of our hearts and lead us in the ways of
freedom. Grant, O God, when we already feel as if we're scraping the bottom barrel for hope. Our bodies and our spirits cannot comprehend the enormity of loss around us. Bless our grief, our rage, and our getting through. Bless our connection, our rest, and our ordinary joy amidst the rubble. Amen.
As we learned last week, we still have to watch out for wind blowing our papers away when we're doing music up here. So I'll get this set and then begin the song.
How it used to be. Nothing on the radio and nothing on TV. Just us and all those owls. The humming roads and singing stars. We could listen in, we could drown it out. We could listen in, we could drown it out. It's a blood test, tell me, are you real? It's a blood test, show me how you feel. It's a blood test, tell me, are you true? like I am to you. Whatever happened to the night is full of buzzing and blazing lights. Trade the darkness for a scream. Lose the moon and just keep the gleam. Are we listening? Are we drowning out? Are we listening?
Truth comes, they will be the one to tell you. They will be your one true spirit guide and will lead you down the path of truth. They will fully represent me and will tell you only what I have told them. The spirit will show you what is coming on the road ahead. They will honor me by making known to you everything I have shown them. All that I am and all that I have comes from the Father. He has not held back one thing from me, and the Spirit will not hold back anything.
So today we're going to do another Bible time for 10 minutes, and if you're joining us on the line, so feel free to write in the comments. Good news. The Spirit is the comforter, and how so often the hardest news to accept is our true belonging in the world.
Goodness.
And that this belonging is alongside the belonging of all of creation.
to become curious about the ways we can share that invitation or hear that invitation within creation. So I will see everybody in 10 minutes. And if discussion time isn't feeling right for you this morning, I'd invite you to carefully wander, snake aware, remember, but carefully wander right. And just connect with the land. Or go ahead and we'll form one group over here and one group over there, and we'll call you back with a song.
I'm going to sing a song by my friend Spencer DeCroy, which is partly a prayer for and on behalf of people who feel excluded, even wounded, even victimized, sometimes by the concept of prayer and the way it gets used. And Spencer says this song is an attempt to do it better and to make the prayer a passion of weapons.
Amen for the chronically ill and disabled. Amen for I heard.
our brains favor simple explanations, so they depend on the explanations we learn first and come to mind easily. All these innate neurological preferences add up to mean that once we believe a rumor is true, we are more likely to continue sticking with that conclusion. Add in our negativity bias, and we find ourselves sticking to rumors even when they aren't in our best interest. Even when they don't reflect the affirming realities about who we are or who someone else is as a beloved child of the divine. So, this is with whom Jesus has come to share the good news. Humans who have a bias towards negativity and an unfaltering loyalty to beliefs based on discredited information. Oh, Jesus comes into a binary, hierarchical society to share the good news that we are wrong about everything, including and perhaps especially about who we believe ourselves to be. So Jesus comes to spread a new rumor. A rumor about the reality of our unconditional belonging and an intimately connected web of divine love manifest in all life forms. And we kill him. I say this not to bring us all down, okay, but to exemplify just how hard it is to accept our own belonging. To illustrate how threatening we find the affirmation of this belonging to be, that it would inspire such fear and hatred and conspiracy. What a radical risk-taking act it is to circulate rumors of equanimity, interdependence, and unconditional love. Programmed to be faithful to the very worst images of who we are and who others are created to be. What a fantastical, futile act it is to continue the practice of being the church who whispers from every corner of the world these rumors of good news in a world screaming of scarcity, precarity, abuse, and mistrust. And it is there pause here and ask ourselves if it is good news that we are whispering into the world, into this community, into our own inner narrations. It is fair to stop and listen for the possibilities that our hearts are still unready, to become curious about how this unreadiness twists the rumors we accept as true in ways that align with the human-centric, independent, consumeristic world humans work so hard to maintain. In this world of rumors built to subdue, how are we listening for the good news of our own true belonging? How are we learning a new language through which we can share this good news of a world that remains largely unseen and unexperienced? At the land, good news manifests in a community dedicated to connecting with and caring for creation. We express this good news in the work of growing food to feed our neighbors, restoring the prairie ecosystem, and redefining worship. And while we may be unique in these expressions, this church, like every church, is tasked with bringing to life the rumors of good news in all that we do. We show up to church, whether that means sitting on a pew or a bar stool or a hay bale, to strengthen our hearts into a shape which can hold the undeniable realities that in this divine interconnected web, we too belong as an equal and yet irreplaceable part of the sacred order. We come to church in buildings and in bars and on prairies so we can prepare our hearts to hold the truth that we exist neither above nor below, but within the wonder and beauty of a relational, reciprocal entanglement of infinite expressions of the image of Creator, Christ, and Spirit. And this is the rumor that we find so daunting to hold, that our witness in creation is the witness of Christ's forgiveness, of the Spirit's presence, of the Creator's love. We come to church to become the church, spread the rumors of this divine reality which extends to all places, and to all people, and to all creatures. Amen.
invite you into this song of welcome and inclusion. Come as you are. And I especially invite you to sing along with the refrain, which is fairly easy, and it has a tune somewhat similar to Will the Circle Be Unbroken. But we do that in one way. I will also say this song was definitely written pre-COVID. But I think the imagery of inclusion and welcome is still very, very important.
Grace. It's our lyrics, not directions.
Okay. Ordinary and extraordinary. We co-create her story of our relationship.
Dana. There's breakfast.